Everybody, I'm here today with an easy driving lesson on anticipating other driver behavior. In this video, I'll be going over the basics of what you can do to anticipate other driver behavior, and also what you can do as a driver to show other drivers what you plan on doing so that they can anticipate your behavior. Without further ado, let's get right into the video. So essentially, drivers use gestures to communicate what they will be doing, and those gestures allow other drivers to anticipate. So I'm going to explain what some of those gestures are and how you can use them to anticipate other drivers, and also how you can use them to show other drivers so that they can anticipate your behavior. So the first one is where they are looking. Where is the driver looking? Now, oftentimes we look where we want the car to go. So if we are going to be turning right, we are going to be looking towards the right. If we're going to be turning left, we're going to be looking towards the left. If we acknowledge another driver, we're going to be looking towards that driver. If we are looking at an obstruction, chances are we're going to be going around that obstruction. If we're looking at a cyclist or a pedestrian on the road, chances are we're going to be going around that cyclist or that pedestrian on the road. So where they are looking, okay? The next thing is eye contact, okay? If they make eye contact with you, that means most likely they've acknowledged you. Meaning, if you're at a stop sign and you don't know if the other driver knows you're there, if they make eye contact with you, they probably know you're there. It's different than looking at a car. If they're looking at your car, they might be looking past your car at something else on the road. But if they make eye contact with your eyes, that means most likely they know that you're there. Okay? And these are all things that you're looking for in other drivers, as well as things that you should be demonstrating yourself as a driver, okay? The next thing is signaling. If they turn their signal right, that means that they're likely going to be turning right or changing lanes towards the right. If they turn on their left signal or turn their signal left, then the same thing goes. They're probably going to be moving towards the left. Also, if they're signaling right, they very well might be pulling over towards the curb, okay? The next behavior that you can anticipate through is slowing down. If they start to slow down, that means most likely they're going to be turning, or they're going to be coming to a stop at a stop sign, or they're going to be going around something. They're going to be changing what they're doing as a driver. If they're driving the same speed and they're about to hit a stop sign, they're probably not going to stop, right? They might be running the stop sign. However, if they slow down as they approach a stop sign, then that should tell you that, oh wait, they're probably going to stop, okay? And you should be looking for these all together. Now, I'll give you a few hypothetical examples. Let's say I'm at a stop sign and there's another driver. I'm stopped. I'm about to go, but there's another driver and they're not slowing down. They don't make eye contact with me. I'm going to wait. Because even if they do stop, I don't know if they're going to stop. I can't even anticipate whether or not they're going to stop. And if they run that stop sign and I decide to go, beep, accident, I'm going to get T-boned. And yes, it probably won't be my fault, but I'm still going to get into an accident. You know, I'm driving with my kids and potentially my wife. And it's just, you know, like, you don't want to get into an accident, whether it's your fault or not. But on the other hand, if I see them start to slow down and make eye contact with me and potentially even signal right, so I know they're going to be making a right-hand turn, then I can start to slowly proceed because I know most likely they're going to be, you know, stopping at the stop sign and they acknowledge me and they're going to be turning. Does that mean that I'm never going to get T-boned? No, they might just roll right through, even with all of those signs. That's why you proceed with caution. And that's where the difference is between assuming versus anticipating. Okay, anticipating is saying they're probably going to stop. I'm going to start to proceed, but I'm going to be ready to react. Assuming would be, oh, they're going to stop. Let's just go. And you just start driving, looking straight. No. If I am anticipating that they're going to stop, I'm proceeding with caution. I'm looking at them. I'm making sure that they're continuing to slow down. I'm ready to react, to swerve out of the way. However, if I'm assuming, I'm just saying, oh, they are going to stop. And that's where it gets dangerous. That's where it gets iffy. Because if you assume, then, you know, if you assume, it's a bad thing because eventually it's going to work against you and you're going to get into an accident. However, if you anticipate, then that's going to help you as a driver. Now, what can you do as a driver? Sorry about that. I have something in my eye. What can you do as a driver to help other drivers anticipate what you're going to do? Well, you can signal. You can make eye contact. You can use your speed as a gesture, so slow down or accelerate, right? If you accelerate, then that driver knows you're not going to stop. Let's say it's like a yield sign and you think you can make it. You're like going through the yield sign and they're coming this way and you give it gas. That other driver will know you're not going to stop, right? And then they might adjust accordingly. It doesn't mean you're right for doing that, but if that happens, a speed management is a way of gesturing to other drivers so that they can anticipate, you know? So you can control your speed, you can make eye contact, you can signal, you can show where you are looking by like directly moving your head in the direction, but never ever assume. You don't want to assume what other drivers are going to do, and you don't want other drivers to assume what you're going to do, because that's when it gets dangerous and that's when accidents happen. And that's basically it. In this video, I just wanted to talk to you about a driving lesson on anticipating other driver behavior. And I wanted to give you some hypothetical examples. Originally I wanted to do this on the road with other drivers, but I was like, I don't know how I'm going to control, what they're doing, right? I can't control what they're doing in the sense of like, I can't set up a situation where a driver's not going to look at me. And it would also be hard for me to show that driver's face. Like, all you see is my face. So I just figured that I would give you these sort of hypothetical examples, and then hopefully you got a lot from this video, a lot of education and possibly even a little bit of entertainment. We like to call it some educational entertainment, and that's basically it. I really hope that you've enjoyed this driving lesson. If you liked the video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. Let me know what you think down below as a comment, and of course, be sure to subscribe for more great car and driving videos just like this one. And that's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching.